You guys, holy smokes. This only pops up when there are 30,000 people in line.
If we are blessed enough to sell out, then I will be doing pre-sales. This is not sold in stores. This is just on TatiBeauty.com. That's it. Hey guys, welcome to today's video. I have a lot to discuss that is super important, and this is an ongoing issue. So this is not just isolated with my brand. This is every single brand is affected in one way or another issue. And I just need to sit down. I have had too many DMs regarding my own palette. I have in the past had many messages sent about other palettes. This is just a main stage thing that I think needs to be openly discussed, and that is counterfeit makeup. And this is on the heels of watching a really incredible episode of a docuseries on Netflix called Broken. And Marlena, the founder of Makeup Geek, she has a part of the series talking about her journey as a CEO of a really killer makeup brand. I love Makeup Geek. And you know, the whole episode is really dedicated in many ways to how makeup is made and counterfeit makeup. And it is a huge eye opener. And I honestly don't know without watching that episode if I would be sitting down and making this as serious as I feel it needs to be. Because seeing the visuals of how some counterfeit makeup is made and how dangerous it is, and how the outcome of using the wrong counterfeit makeup could cause skin conditions and horrible things, I think that it is my responsibility to share with you guys that my palette is only sold on TatiBeauty.com, period. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. I do not resell anywhere else. I felt it was so important for me to sit here on camera on my channel and not just do like a quick IG story and not just do a quick, you know, tweet or mention about it. Like, this is legit, like, serious stuff because of how dangerous it can be. And even in the Netflix docuseries, you see one girl purchased a liquid lip and it had elements of super glue in the liquid lip, and her lips were stuck together and she damaged her lips trying to scrub it off. So if you have ever been tempted to purchase counterfeit makeup, I want to urge you guys to think long and hard about what you're doing. You might purchase something and have no reaction to it, but you're feeding the monster and you are participating in the problem. This palette is coming back. Like, I'm not even gonna pretend like that there's, I'm not even gonna market it that way where it's like, buy it now or you'll never get it. I felt comfortable with the amount that we had, and I was very transparent. I have never seen anyone else, by the way, put their numbers up on Twitter. I feel that transparency needs to actually exist and not just be talked about. I am willing to put my numbers out there on a sell-through so that you guys see that I'm not playing games with you. I am not holding back inventory because I wanted to create anxiety in the market. Like, I made as much as I could because it costs money to make palettes. Like, this is not a cheap palette to make, by the way. This palette is not, you know, a $3, $5, $10, and then marked way up palette. This palette is blood, sweat, tears. The formula is so good. The time that it takes to make some of the shadows in here is not just a single pressing. There are steps that it goes through to become this physical palette here. You're paying for the formula, and you're not gonna find that in a counterfeit product. If people saw how some counterfeit makeup is being made, I don't think anyone would buy it. And I've long said, before being on YouTube, I you know, way back when, like, let's travel back in time. I'm really into the study of nutrition in the human body. I'm fascinated by it. For a long while, I thought I would go back to school and that I would be a nutritionist, because when I quit dancing, I gained a bunch of weight and I had to educate myself on how to lose weight. I was literally on an all McDonald's Frappuccino diet, Oreo diet. Tasted great. I felt like awful all the time. So I read and adapted. It was really important to me to get organic vegetables. And I think my family thought I had lost my mind. So I would try to get my mom to take me downtown to go to Whole Foods, or I'd try to get a girlfriend to come with me and like make a trip of it, because they weren't everywhere. And I have long said, the way we change the world is by voting with our wallets. So a lot of us got on board with the idea of health, wellness, nutrition, feeling good. And Whole Foods, I mean, they're now, you know, Amazon, they're making a great profit. It's money, it's business and all of that. But we have better access now because we all voted with our wallets and our interest. So I feel with cosmetics, like looking at that and looking at this and the idea of voting with your wallet, do it. Don't buy this stuff. We can collectively stop this problem. You can help put an end to the risk that people are putting themselves in buying counterfeit makeup, because you can get a staph infection, pink eye, a sty. You can have horrible, you know, contact dermatitis. There are things that can happen from using these ingredients that are not safe and are often listed incorrectly. So even if it says this is what the product contains, they have found more often than not when they do testing, when products are brought in and confiscated, that it's not even the correct ingredient listing. So you don't know what you're using. It looks like my product. If you go and you see the three sites that are pre-selling my palette right now, it's a part of Alibaba. They're literally using my imagery, my photography, all of that. Like really, like, do I have the Game of Thrones like shame bell? Like shame. That's how I feel like when people order counterfeit. But with one of the sites, you do get a free Lady Gaga eyeliner. You might go blind. So I just wanted to hop on and let you guys know, A, this problem is a big problem. It's getting worse as the industry grows and booms with more brands launching. And, you know, until we all collectively get more open about it and stop purchasing these items, it's not gonna stop because it's a huge moneymaker. Also, I wanna let you guys know, this is something I just thought of today, and it's a big part of also why I wanted to sit down. A lot of the time you will go to a retailer online that in your head you think is very, very safe. You might go to eBay, you might go to Amazon, and do not get me wrong, like I shop there too. Like I love Amazon, Like hello, hey Seattle, what's up? I love Amazon. I recently purchased a bunch of Sonicare brush heads for my toothbrush, and they were fakes. And it's not like they were like dangerous, like I'm ingesting or putting something on my eyes, but it was like really disappointing. And it's hard for them to manage all of that, I'm imagining. But even on like Amazon, if you find a Tati Beauty palette from a reseller and you're thinking, oh my gosh, someone like bought Tati Beauty palettes from TatiBeauty.com, and because they're so special and they're sold out, they are going to be charging $100 for that palette. And that means that it's real. And I am here to tell you the problem gets deeper, because it does not mean it's real. They are fooling you. That is probably a counterfeit item. This becomes an issue that is so deep and so layered, because then people are doing reviews on counterfeit products thinking they are the legit thing. It's bad for the brand. It's bad for the consumer. It's bad for all these different platforms. And it's bad for your wallet. Why are you going to spend $100 on a product that eventually will be restocked anyway? Please don't do that. I am gonna restock. I am not gonna just be like, sorry, we're sold out forever. You missed your opportunity. I hope you behave better next time and have more anxiety and get in line. That's not what I'm about. I'm about real, like, fun of makeup and the process and how beautiful it is and how empowering it is. And I'm never gonna lose that. I've come this far that it's not just about the money. And I wanna address something just very boldly. I'm fine being about the money. I like money. I like the comfort that it gives me. I like that I don't have to stress out about if something happens to my family medically. I can help people that I love in my life. I can help issues that I have had to address and deal with that I have always wanted to. I like the stable feeling that I get coming from not having a lot to having a lot. So I will never say like, money's the root of all evil. It's just bad. It's terrible. You shouldn't want to be successful. Like it's the bad guy here. No, it's not. Money's not the problem. How you go about getting it is the problem. And when you fall out of your moral code to get it, when you fall out of ethics to get it, when you fall out of pursuing the better version of yourself to get it and you take steps back, that's the bad part. When you bend, I am still learning, I am still growing, I am still chasing the woman that I want to be. I get close, and then I raise the bar. And then I get closer, and then I raise the bar. And I think that that is a really great way to look at life and to live life. It's not about being flawless and perfect. It's about the willingness to want to do better. And if you find yourself in this pivotal moment of chasing success and it looks like the road is divided, continue to chase yourself because this is a dead end over here. Like, work hard, get what's yours, earn. Dream of success, dream of the things you feel you want to experience. But it's like the choices we make to make money, if they're bad choices, like that's what I don't agree with. So a lot of people are like, oh, you don't make YouTube and Tati Beauty just for free. Like, yeah, I know that. I'm making it because it's my job and what a dream come true. But I'll tell you one thing, I will always sit down here and talk to you guys like this and tell you what's up. This is what I'm upset about right now. I think a lot of brands are upset about this. And I think it feels like just this incurable disease because it's like you mend one part of it and another one pops up with like two more heads. Like that's how it feels. And that's kind of how it feels like, you know, I made the video a while back of like advertisers that use me without my permission. I have a love affair with these. They are so good. Look at these colors. And I still, to this day, get probably 20 different messages saying, hey, someone's using your magnetic lash video or this lipstick video. And companies will create ads for their knockoff products using my likeness in a commercial. And I need to spend my time and effort and resources chasing my dream, creating products versus sitting with my lawyer and legal team and suing the bad guys because sadly, there are a lot of them. It's not manageable. So what I am suggesting instead is that those of us out there that love makeup, make that vote with your wallet and don't purchase counterfeit items. Do your research, find out who you're purchasing from. When it comes to products, where it is made, I really insisted on having a brand be made here in the US. That was so important to me so that I could really understand what was going on. I wanted to see it. I wanted to touch it. I wanted to feel it. I wanted to know that it was a pure product, that it was being tested for impurities and contaminants, that everything that was brought in as far as raw materials, that we were all like, you know, check, 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 off the list, A-okay, safe as can be. That is important to me. And, you know, a lot of people have an issue. I mean, mine is a pressed pigment. Okay, let's talk about that. Let's just go there. Some of the eyeshadows in the Tati Beauty palette are, per the FDA, not eye safe. They do meet EU regulation, which is interesting because their regulations are a little bit more strict. In the US, there are some things that are like, sure. And like you go over and it's like, no, 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 we would never. So their regulations are a bit more strict and this palette does abide by them. We do put a note that the glitters are not intended for use around the eyes. And you know, that is safety to the brand. That is safety for you. Like, don't go rubbing glitter in your eyes. Like, you don't want to do that. And if you don't feel comfortable using glitter on your eyes, You know, you can use it on the high points of your cheek, your body, your hair. You can use it how you wish to. I made sure when making this that it was like a very sticky, tacky base where there wouldn't be fluff getting everywhere. But also, counterfeit, they can be using metals that will rust, that could cut your eye, that are not cosmetic grade, and that's really dangerous. And that thought is like horrifying to me. I don't want that out there with my name on it. That really bothers me. The pressed pigments, that whole issue, I had to decide one avenue or another. Either I use carmine, which is crushed beetles, gross. I think that's disgusting, okay? Like, I don't like carmine in makeup. It's in a lot of makeup. It's usually in reds. I'm not vegan, but it was a way for me to demonstrate that I wanted as many people as possible to have access to using my products. I did the same thing for Halo, because it's not just about me. There are many different lifestyles out there, and I wanted to make it comfortable for everyone. Yeah, so it gets a little tricky with like the knockoffs. It's like, is it still gonna be vegan? Are people gonna assume that it's vegan and it's not? What's the glitter made of? Is it metal? Is it gonna rust? Is it gonna hurt someone's eye and they think it's my product because it looks identical? Like, this is a huge issue. Buyer beware, I had to let you guys know about this. The only place that you are going to get a legit Tati Beauty Textured Neutrals Volume 1 palette, because that's the only palette I have right now, is on TatiBeauty.com. Please don't purchase this elsewhere. It's not the right thing to do. And if you want recommendations for products that are not the price point of this, I get that. And I literally filmed today with drugstore makeup, and I'm not gonna stop reviewing awesome products at every price point. So I'm gonna give you the tools that you need to know to go wherever you go to shop and purchase makeup that is phenomenal, that you can trust. So I hope that this was eye-opening, informative, and you know, I think we can all make a positive change. Like, how cool. Like, I love using my platform for positive change. And I think this is a great start in things that do matter and need to be corrected in the beauty industry. Because you know what? There is so much good here. And I will keep saying that over and over and over. The beauty community is not bad. I would say majority of it is great. I would say there are a few things that are not the greatest that we all kind of hop on and sink our teeth into. But at the end of the day, the love of makeup and transformation is a wonderful thing. So let's just all band together, make better purchasing decisions together, and, you know, root for a positive change with this. All right, thanks for hanging. I will have a normal beauty video up next week, and I hope you guys come back and check that out. Subscribe, ring the bell, come see me again. I would love that. And go have a good one, whatever you are doing. And I will see you in my next video. Mwah.